Hello, my name is Terrance Gallegos. I'm an operations trainee with the Southwest Team 5, and I'm here to explain how we utilize a helicopter and a PSD machine to do some aerial firing. So if you look at the map here, you can see this fire's edge has a big U-shape in it. And if we allowed the fire to just move naturally down into some of these canyons, the fire would want to then turn around and run up the hill. And when fire runs up the hill, it has much more high severity and higher severity fire effects. So what we do with the helicopter and the PSD machine is we can bring it in here and light the top of this ridge, so tiny little ping pong balls fall out of the machine, and there's about a 5 or 6 second delay, and then the ping pong balls light on fire, and so we can put some fire on the top of these ridges so that the fire backs down into these steep drainages, as opposed to the fire running up the steep drainages. So that's how we can limit fire severity utilizing a PSD machine. So we can get a square edge of fire, which is usually a lot better to deal with, and we get better fire effects from it. The other aspect of a PSD machine is it provides a lot of safety to our fire personnel. So as opposed to hiking firefighters into this really steep, nasty country, we can utilize the helicopter, keep the firefighters out of that steep terrain, and still meet the fire effects that we want to achieve.
Hi, my name is Matt with the Prescott Helitack. This is our helicopter, 98 Tango Echo. It's an AS350B3. This has been the aerial ignition platform for the Frye Fire. We're going to go over an installation of our PSD machine, and we're going to start with taking off the doors here. Virg, you want to give me a hand? So the installation is always done on the right. Once the doors are off, we're going to go ahead and start with pulling the machine out. We're going to get it all put into the helicopter, and then we're going to do a bench test. That's going to be to determine what the delay is on our ignition for the plastic spheres. Okay, so what they've installed so far is this little piece of cardboard, which is going to protect the helicopter, the paint basically, from any scratches that the chute on the PSD machine might give the helicopter. This is an insert, it's an addition to the PSD machine, and it's a sill basically. Different helicopters have different kinds of door sills. This one, there's a little opening on the PSD machine for this to sit over, so it's more fixed into the helicopter. Yeah, if you want to see how those actuate. So this is the mainframe. Right inside here, you see four chambers. There's the slipper blocks. And each of those, there's four chutes on the window that they're going to bring out next. It's called the hopper. And there's going to be four chambers that get filled with PSD spheres. And they're going to drop into these four chambers, and those, they're actuated, so they're going to start plunging into a needle belly strap to the helicopter. So it's going to go starting from these points here. It's going to go underneath the belly of the helicopter, and then it's going to come back through and secure the machine to the belly and affix it permanently. This is the chute that's just going to allow the balls to fall between the skids and the skin of the helicopter.
Silver City, I drive this branch to Command 1.
on top of the machine, there's a gallon of water. It's emergency water, and it's to be used in case of a hang fire. If a sphere gets stuck in the machine, into the chute, and it will not fall through the chambers, it's gonna cause a fire, and you're gonna use the emergency water to extinguish it. We use this red bag here, which is about 1,000 spheres. It'll hold about 1,000 spheres. And in the helicopter, what we use to attach it to is a carabiner that's affixed to a hard point in the helicopter. So there's a ring right here that comes up through the seat, and we attach these straps to this hook here. So prior to the bench test, things that we're gonna need, first thing is we're gonna need a bucket, a metal bucket that has some dirt in there, because that's what we're gonna be dropping the spheres into. And from there, they're gonna catch fire. We're gonna need a tool, obviously, to make sure that these spheres don't fly out of the bucket. Once they get punctured with glycol and that reaction starts to occur, it'll heat up and it has potential to leave the bucket in a fast manner. This is the hopper. It has a few parts to it. One is the lid, and then we have a handle here. And then this is our plexiglass window, which allows us to see spheres inside that are preloaded, ready to go into the four chambers to be punctured with glycol. This is the mechanism that allows you to go with how many spheres you want to release at a time. When you have one of these bars open, it's going to allow only two of these chambers to release chutes. The rest will be stopped up in this point here until this lever is pulled, and then you'll have all four. So Virgil's filling the hopper, and as you can see, you have all the viewing windows are full. The last thing to check when we are doing our bench test is to make sure that the agitator inside the hopper works. There's an agitator, it's a plate with four rails on it, and it'll allow the spheres to be agitated so they don't get hung up. Okay. Yep, I did. Ready, Paul? Go.
Because sometimes they jump out.
Yeah, they do.
If you don't have sand, they'll go, since the bucket is cylindrical, and they'll actually roll up and shoot out. I had a couple words.
When we get over an area to drop the PSD balls, we first do a high level recon above 500 feet off the ground, and then we come down lower and have a closer look at the area that we intend to burn. While that's all going on, the burn boss in the front is having a conversation on the radio with all pertinent people on the ground to make sure that they are clear from the area that we intend to burn, and also that it aligns with their plan on the ground. Once we do that, and that's all squared away, we come down and do a dry run. So we get down into the flight profile lower, typically on top of a ridgeline, and we fly exactly how we intend to fly, just not dropping any balls. And if anything is not good on the dry run, we abort the mission for that area, or we choose to fly it in a different flight profile.